Today we'll be looking at the RE3 light kit, a great lighting option for your projects. Before checking this or any other equipment out from the cage, you'll need to pass the quizzes showing you know how to appropriately operate the equipment. To set up the lights, take out a light stand and loosen the knob on the legs. Spread the legs and tighten the knob. Take a light and place it on top of the stand and use the knob to secure it. These lights can also be attached to C-stands for more versatile setups. To attach the barn doors, slide them into place and use the spring latch to secure it. You can also use scrims in a similar fashion if you want to lower the intensity of the light. Barn doors are great for shaping and controlling light or attaching gels and diffusion. To use the chimera, remove everything from the bag. Place the metal rods in the slots, then put them in the attachment ring. Remove the barn doors from the light, then put the chimera in its place. Velcro the flaps in place. The chimera can only be used on the 650. To use the lights, first make sure the power switch is in the off position. Find a good outlet to plug the light into and turn the light on. Be sure to call striking and make sure no one is looking into the light when you turn it on. The angle of the light can be adjusted by loosening the fastening knobs on the side. You can also adjust the light pattern from the spot to flood with the knob on the back. Be sure to wear gloves when handling the light while it's on. These lights get extremely hot very quickly. Before striking the lights, allow them to cool for 15 to 20 minutes. Remove the light and wrap the cord. The chimera can be tricky to strike, but with a little muscle power, you can pop the metal rods right out and place them back in the bag. These lights are great for shooting interviews, talking heads, or anything requiring a 3-light setup. An RE4 light kit is also available in the cage.